You remember Dickie Moltisanti?
No.
No?
Is he a friend of yours?
He was my father.
You know, your father was like a mentor to me. Stand up, you ask anybody. Your old man was a legend.
Caro mio, fammi presentare mio figlio, Richard Moltisanti.
Everybody calls me Dickie. Oh, Antonio Soprano.
Dad, are you in the mafia?
My father was in it. My uncle was in it.
You ever miss him?
He was in prison, but since he's been dead.
You knew my father. You grew up around Dickie Moltisanti and your Uncle Eddie. You knew the deal.
Deal? The TV series, The Sopranos crew always harkened back.
I think about my father. In a lot of ways, he had it better.
We rewind back to the late 60s and 70s.
He had his people. They had their standards. They had pride.
And we explore how the tough guys and gals of the series came to be how they were.
Uncle Dick, think fast.
Oh, you want to fight, huh?
Dickie Moltisanti, the father of Christopher. It's really his story.
Got myself a son.
We never saw Dickie in the show.
My mother can't even talk about it.
But his presence sort of loomed large.
He's a character that has only been talked about in a kind of fantasy way.
Loyal, your old man.
Tony had a lot of reverence for him, and I think even referred to him as the great Dickie Moltisanti.
Tony Soprano, we see him as a young boy, and we see him as a young teen.
Anthony got kicked out of school.
Let me go talk to him.
He only listens to Dickie.
His uncle's influence on him is what will turn the teenager into the all-powerful mafioso who we all love, Tony Soprano.
You took an oath, and you broke it.
I think I'm most excited for the fans to see all the characters that they know from the show.
It's weird how people love Livia. And they love Junior, the two crabbiest, unpleasant people.
You're making me very upset.
I don't like Olivia, but I'm all agita all the time.
Corey and Vera are doing an amazing job. How they sound, how they move, how they walk. I mean, it's surreal.
My uncle adds to my general stress level.
My legal problems have let you go strutting around like a gob of fish.
Dominic's performance is brilliant. From the pilot, he had that character down.
You may run North Jersey, but you don't run your Uncle Junior.
It was incredibly funny, scary.
I love the man.
He's petty, pissy.
In this movie, he is not the Junior that we know, but he still is that same guy.
Ah, you sisters!
I try to do the right thing by you, and you try to have me whacked? She's smiling! Look at the look on her face! Look at the look on her face! She's smiling!
She is the best. It doesn't get any better than Nancy Marchand. She was just jaw-dropping, hilarious, appalling. Heavy is the Olivia crown on my head.
Get inside! Both of you.
What she's captured with Livia is this kind of victimhood that the world is against her.
I made your favorite pizza again, even though it's not Easter.
And at the same time, you just innately feel that she is gonna conquer everybody.
I can't take it anymore.
Oh, boy, you.
Hey, Uncle Dick, it's Tony. How's it going? I'm Michael Gandolfini, and I play Tony Soprano.
When we decided to do Tony at 15, I thought we should definitely try Michael.
And it became very clear that he's the only person who could play this role.
It was incredible. Just the little mannerisms. It's actually kind of eerie sometimes.
I mean, it's terrifying, right? It's absolutely terrifying. The fact that, like, this is a great character and it's loved by a lot of people.
Do you have any qualms about how you actually make a living?
Yeah.
And then there's the fact that it's my dad, and like, I really want to do a good job for him.
This became a whole other thing. James lives on in him. It's genetics, it's poetic, it's beautiful, it's heartbreakingly beautiful.
Once you enter this family, there's no getting out.
It's a very American theme, this sort of idea that you can create your own destiny.
You've been listening to me? We're soldiers. It's war.
my Uncle Tony.
You don't gotta love me, but you will respect me.
The guy I'm going to hell for. I'd like to propose a toast to my family.